What has this been like for you the past 5 or 6 days? Just the whole whirlwind.
Well, you know, it's been the first couple of days is a little bit awkward.
Mm-hmm.
But you know, like I was confident, and I was not really not really upset or not really scared about not finding a job. So
mm-hmm.
I was just going through the days and spend time with the family and just waiting to see what was going to happen.
At any point, you know, when this happens, Miguel, are you sitting there saying, in your mind anyhow, okay, that, you know, somebody call? You know, were you getting anxious at all, or how hard was it to be patient? Especially because it's in season, right? It's different if it's the off season, but it's in season.
Yeah, you know what? The first couple of days, I probably was a little bit of, anxious to see, like, if somebody was going to call or something like that. But after that, I mean, it was 5 days. It was fairly quick. But after the second or third day, I didn't even call my agent. I'm like, yeah, I'm just going to let it happen. I'm just going to stay calm and just spend the time here with the family. Just not really going to pressure or nothing like that. I'm just going to, let it happen.
Mm-hmm. You know, Miguel, I was talking to Arash Madani of Sportsnet before this. You've played almost 1,150 games in the majors, 9 years with Arizona, 3 with Chicago. Is it, you know as well as anybody, you come here as, well, that was the guy that said what he said about Jake Arrieta and the Cubs pitching staff. It's kind of unfair, isn't it, that a guy can play 12 years and one thing is, you know, the thing that's held against him?
Yeah, that was the one thing that kind of got upset about, because, for the most part, I had a good reputation in my career. And then just leave Chicago with that reputation, I felt like, I felt bad about it. I felt devastated, because that wasn't me. That's not the guy that did. I'm not the guy that they talking that way. You know, I'm not that guy, and that kind of hurt me. But, but it's what it is. It's in the past. I'm okay. I know as long as I'm good with myself, I'm okay. I know I'm not that guy, so I'm okay with that.
How hard is it for you to join a team, mid-season? Now you got to learn new pitchers. It's the American League. I know with Interleague Baseball, that's less of an issue, perhaps, than it was in the past, because you've seen some of these American League teams. But how hard is it going to be for you, or how much work are you going to have to do kind of learning your own pitchers and learning the league itself?
No, it's still challenging. It's still challenging because one thing is when you face those guys, and the other thing is when you're behind the plate.
Mm-hmm.
So obviously it's kind of something new for me, but I've done it before, so I don't see it any problem to adapt. And I'm going to do my homework So I can get a little bit more comfortable as quick as possible.
What do you consider to be your strengths as a catcher defensively? Because you have the reputation of being a pretty good pitch framer. Is that something you've always worked on, or is that something that kind of just comes naturally the more you catch again?
Yeah, I mean, I guess that's something that it comes natural, because I'm not even worried about that, and I think that's something that I feel like is a little bit overrated.
Mm-hmm.
I just try to catch the ball clean and try to give the umpires a good look. I mean, I don't try to steal any strike.
Mm-hmm.
In catching, I just like everything about catching. I like, I like to help the pitcher to throw a good game. And, as a catcher, I trade 0-for-4 with a 7-inning shutout and a winning game.
What do you know about your new team? Are there any players in the team that you've kept in contact with, or that you've known from previous your previous years?
And where, here?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, I played pretty much all the way to the minor league with Tulo, and obviously in the big league when it was with the Rockies for a long time.
Mm-hmm.
Russell and Morales, those are the three guys that I kind of saw more often playing against him, but I really never really knew him.
Right.
we just talk, you know, when they come in the box and say, hey, what's up? And that was it. Or maybe a fastball in, they didn't like it. And, you know how baseball goes.
Yep. There's a lot of communication that goes on as the game's being played.
Yeah. So, but yeah, you know, I played with, I guess, those guys. And they were tough outs, man. And that's why I didn't like him back then when I was against him.
Mm-hmm.
Because I'm a catcher. I want to get him out. So, they received me here pretty good, and they're all great guys. They're all good teammates. They're all good players, and they've been very successful in their careers. And it's good to be around those guys.
What did John Gibbons, the manager, say to you about how he plans on using you? Has he said exactly?
No, he really didn't say anything exactly. And like I told him, I don't care. You use me how you want. I'm here for you, and I'm ready to do whatever you need me to do. And whenever you need me, I'm here. So I really don't need a, like at this point, I don't need to know like what my role was going to be because I don't care what my role is. My role is here to help the team to win, and that's the bottom line.
Miguel, listen, we really appreciate you joining us a couple of hours before game time today. Thanks so much. Again, welcome to Toronto. Welcome to the Blue Jays, and go get them.
All right, man. Thank you.